Sam, when we first met, it wasn't fireworks, love at first sight, or anything like that for me. The truth was is that I thought you were way out of my league. You are outgoing, kind, stylish, funny, beautiful, the list goes on and on. I was in awe of you, and my best man Sully can attest to me, talking about how awesome you were daily for that first week of training. When our friend and your fairy godmother told me how the feeling was mutual, the spark met fuel and a fire was lit. From karaoke at the Yi Dynasty to our first date at the Copper Door, things started to warm up. The saying, opposites attract, fit us perfectly. I started to really fall for your innocence, wonderful personality, and caring heart. You truly are the beauty to my beast, or better yet, the Fiona to my shrub. While we were still opposites in many ways, we slowly started agreeing on one commonality. We love each other. I had my future goals, you had yours, and together they became ours. We have been knocking them out one by one ever since. Job to house, to school to marriage, even your first kickboxing match. I'm so proud of you, and we have helped each other become better every step of the way. You have not only accepted me and my faults, you have also accepted Layla, who has no faults, and have shown me how to be a better father while becoming an amazing stepmother. I'm sure this is not how you envisioned your Prince Charming. 12 years older, a 3-year-old daughter, baggage from earlier years, and an addiction to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Howard Stern. And yet, here we are, about to become husband and wife. So with our family and friends watching, and hopefully God and our family and friends who have passed, I say these vows to be true from this day forward. I vow to support you, mentally, physically, and emotionally. Calm you down after a bad day, get you soup when you're sick, and wipe away your tears no matter how many, or whether they are from laughing or crying. When we go through cloudy days and tough times, I vow to keep a smile on my face and look for the silver lining. I vow to let you run and jump into my arms, and I will always catch you no matter how bad my back gets. I vow to protect you and our family, and if anyone tries to harm us, I will do as Shrek says and make soup from their freshly peeled skin, shave their liver, and squeeze jelly from their eyes. One last vow. I said earlier how I thought you were out of my league when we first met. I said in front of Brent, my friend, once, adding how I didn't deserve you. He said, what are you talking about? Sam's great and you deserve her because you're a great guy. Never forgetting those words. Thanks, Brent, wherever you are. Somewhere in there, all right? I vow to always be that great guy for you because you're great, and the day I stop is the day I no longer deserve someone as wonderful as you.
So now vows are supposed to be things that I promise you through our marriage. But there are some things that I just can't promise. I can't promise that I won't warm up my cold feet on your legs. I can't promise that not odd numbers will ever be acceptable on the volume guitar. And I can't promise that I won't laugh when you put gloves on to eat chicken wings. And I can't promise I'll ever stop watching Shrek. I can, however, promise to turn the light off before coming to bed. I can promise to always listen to you and care about your interests. I'll support you. I will keep an open mind when you have a crazy, spontaneous idea. And I promise to compromise no matter how difficult that is for me. I'll also continue to grow as an individual and allow you the space to do the same. I promise to grow with you and love you each step of the way. I hope to continue to learn about you. I hope to work as a team with you. When I am weak, you are strong. And when you need a boost, I will always be there. Then, now, and forever, you are mine.
I'm ready to marry the most beautiful girl in the world. Better believe it.
Give this woman to this man.
Thank you.
I was so honored when the two of you asked if I would be willing to officiate your wedding.
I've known you, Dan, for such a long time, and I'm so thrilled for you and Layla and Sam with all her energy, enthusiasm, and fun swept into your lives and stole your hearts. It's impossible to be near the two of you and not feel the depth of your love and respect for each other. Sam, you've been lucky to find that man who is one in a million. He will treasure, protect, and hold your heart safely within his for all eternity. Dan knew without a doubt you were the woman he would love forever when you presented him with a photograph of Layla and him holding hands. See, the day that picture was taken was not the greatest of days. You had all gone to pick out a pumpkin, but the day was miserably long and it was hot. And at some point you snapped that picture without their knowledge. When you gave that picture to Dan, you may remember it made him cry. See, you managed to find and capture the most perfectly beautiful moment on a truly miserable day. And Dan knew that was who you were. You are that person who was able to find a beautiful moment in even the most difficult of days. And he wanted you to be a part of his and Layla's life forever. Dan, Sam first noticed how special you were when she entered your training session at Easter Seals. Instead of paying attention to your lesson, she began texting in earnest all those who knew and were close to you. She was interested but guarded, and with the encouragement of a few of us present here today, she decided to give you a chance, and now here you both are.
You can come over, Sean. When I met your dad, I knew I loved him. And when I met you, I knew why. You make him an honest, kind, caring man. And I hope to help dad raise you to be all of these things and more. You are such a smart, beautiful, funny, energetic girl. And I want to tell you how happy I am to be your life. Marrying dad means uniting us as a family. And I'm so, so ready. Always remember that I will always be here for you, to support you, to help you with your homework, to give you crazy hairdos, and to torture dad with a guacamole dance. I love you and thank you for sharing your dad with me.
Is just what Samantha needs to get out of her own head sometimes. And Samantha, your weirdly organized file cabinet, list-making brain helps Dan, I don't know, remember to shower or something. Because showering is literally on her lists. But seriously, love each other like crazy. Cherish every one of the beautiful moments you share when you're alone. Continue to respect each other like you do. And find balance between the two of you. You are truly exceptional together. And I'm so blessed to be getting another brother today. Thank you for being the Shrek to my sister Fiona. Thank you for managing her crazy and pulling some of the weight off my shoulders. I love you both.
How about it?